five, six knots, but it's against the current, so there's a bit of a chop out there. Nothing too bad at all. But, and we're doing 5.4 knots over ground, 5.8 through the water, and we're running at about 2,000 RPM. Beautiful day. A little bit of a haze in the air, but that'll clear up as the day wears on. That's White Rock, British Columbia over there. And Orca's having a fine ride here. Everything's working just perfectly. If anything exciting shows up, I'll be back. The wind picked up a bit, so we got a few white caps out there, but still nothing too bad. I would guess these waves are about maybe 3 feet. Some of the bigger ones might be going to 4 foot, but Orca's handling it very well, no problem. The worst condition for this boat is if the wind was on our beam, because the boat tends to roll. But I do have a steadying sail I can put up to help dampen that a bit. We're just going along. Coming up on Birch Bay, it's kind of blanketed in fog right now. You can't see much of it. Here's the view out of the back of the boat. My new sailing dinghy is following us along, bouncing around in the waves. As you can see, it's a really nice day. I would say the temperature must be 65 or so, maybe a little more. Well, we're still banging around out here. It got a little rough there for a while, but it's calmed down again now. And we're about a little better than halfway across the strait here, and those islands up ahead, not straight ahead, just at those islands, and that other island to the left of it is Susha, and we're going to go right between the two. If you can see that, there's a gap there between the two. That's where we're headed. When we get up there, it should calm down considerably once the wind is blocked by the islands. I hope so, anyway. Be a little smoother going. Well, we're just coming up on the gap between Patos Island, which is right over there, and over here is Susha Island. And we're going to shoot the gap right between them and head down President's Channel. You can see it, but right up ahead is a current tide line. It's always right in here, and when you go through it, it looks like the water's dancing. It's going up and down, up and down, up and down. When we get to it, I'll film again. Okay, we're almost up to the tide line. You can see it. Better on this side. We're rolling a bit through here. Coming the very worst possible direction for this boat. comes another one. That wasn't too bad. And we should be almost through. Susha Island, and we're looking into Shallow Bay right there, where you see the sailboat coming out and other boats in there. And then a little further up, we can look up into Fox Cove and see what's going on there. And then over here is Petho's Island. On the other end of that island, away from us, is a really nice little cove, active cove, and we stayed there one night, and it was just really ideal setting, but there's only space for two boats in there. There's only two mooring buoys, and I guess anchoring is not recommended. So straight ahead here is President's Channel. That was the VHF radio blaster. Shoot up that, go around the bottom of Orcas Island, and we'll almost be at our destination. Probably another couple of hours travel time. Here's a better view of Shallow Bay, Ocean Island, a few boats in there, and a sailboat heading out. And my dinghy's still with us. Haven't lost it. Thank goodness. My brand new sailing dinghy. I hope to try it out for the first time today. Or at least today or tomorrow. Just to give you a look around here. Over there is Boundary Bay. Those islands you're looking at now are in Canada, and Boundary Bay, of course, is the boundary between Canada and the U.S. This would be Waldron Island here, and that little one to the right is Skipjack Island. Big Island, just heading into the port, the left-hand side, that's Orcas Island. And we're going to go down President's Channel, which is this space here. And we're going to go down around the bottom and curve over. And you can see there's a few sailboats out. There's not much wind, but there's a little bit. So if I had my sailboat, I'd be sailing too. And then over here is Waldron Island. It's all private, no place to anchor or stay there at all. But it's calmed down considerably, as you can see by the flatness of the surface of the water. Thank goodness, that was kind of a rough ride. Back that way, that is Petho's Island, and behind us, you can see it, is Susha. That's the pass we just came through. Kind of a overcast day, but it's a nice day. It's pleasant, probably mid-60s temperature-wise, something like that. Okay. I'll get more video when we get down a little further, and we're going to be going through Pole Pass, so I'll try to film that if I can. Still going down President's Channel, and that island over there, the camera's pointing at. Jones Island. There's a couple of nice anchorages on Jones Island, but we're going to be turning left just about where that sailboat is, if you can see it, and then going between Jones and Orcas and cutting over that way. Here's where we're going to go. Here's our boat, and we're going to come down through here, around, up through here, and down Pole Pass, and then over to Blaine Bay, which is a little further. 6 knots at 2,000 RPM. There is Jones Island, and we're looking right into the northern anchorage. There's another one on the south side of the island. Nice island, nice anchorage. There's some trails to hike and things to do in there, but it's usually pretty busy in the summertime. I usually stop there in the winter cruising. There's a whole mess of birds in the water just up ahead. There must be some food there for them, or they wouldn't be there. Looks like seagulls. Okay, coming up on Cole Pass. Looks like another boat's coming through the other way, so I'll slow down a bit. I'm in through first. He's almost through. bay and find an anchoring spot. Works like a charm. Let's see, I can show it to you here. Attaches to the anchor road and comes up in a harness around both sides so that the load of the anchor is not on the windlass. It's on the bridle, and it's split side so the boat doesn't go off in one direction. It works great, and I thank you, Lou, for letting me steal that idea. Give me a look around the anchorage. Another boat coming in. There's the opening to Harney Channel and Blaine Island.